Do you love it?
If he asked me again, I think I would say yes. Do you think he'll ask me again?
But do you love it?
I care more to be loved. I want to be loved. Roughly 2 years ago, I made a poem that does not have a title, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't have a meaning. I wrote it in English, even though it's not my first language. I later translated it to my own language, but I can never forget this first draft. Even if it is a mess, I think it is still worth sharing. It goes as follows. So dancing with the men I fuck, but never date. Feels like so dancing with a corpse so voided of hope. Like putting my arms around memories that can never be. Like falling for someone who I don't deserve. Laying my head in a chest that I shall not touch. Not now, not ever, but I still do. Because it's warm. His shirt is soft and I am cold, and the path to me is rough. And he needed a hug, but I need a friend. And he needed a partner, but I needed a place to land. Feeling lost and scared to pull away. I don't want to see his face. I don't want to take responsibility for holding on for too long. Because I'm just lonely, that is all. After he's gonna want more, but I have no more to offer, and he will leave, and I'll have no arms to hold. So I'll warm myself with all that I could have been, if only I admitted that I wanted him to stay, to not leave, to be with me. But it becomes so hard to look at someone when you realize you've fallen, that you've lost, and you surrendered to the charm. So I might have held on for too long, but I don't want to slow dance with him anymore. I do believe that the Portuguese version of this is superior, because even though I come here and I speak in English, I do believe that my vocabulary is still a little bit limited. I try to read a lot in English, but I think nothing beats your own language. There is no other way to express yourself better than speaking your own language, but I wrote in English first, so that must mean something. I think this poem is a little bit of a redemption of what I wanted to say in the last video I published, speaking on idealization and relationships. The video was not as I expected it to be. I feel like I failed a little bit because I've been waiting for so long to publish something just to publish that. Not that it is bad, but the audio is killing me and I'm so sorry. Also, it is a really long video. And I remember this poem because I wasn't satisfied with what I've given you guys. And I think it resumes pretty much my feelings on the situation. I think on that video, I exited the context, and I let myself bring a lot of quotes and a lot of movies to reference and to express my feelings, because I thought that preparing something beforehand, preparing the slides, would guide me to a more cohesive train of thought. But in doing so, I didn't express my opinions fully, and I feel like a lot of what I do in this channel is just be myself and speak my opinions. I felt like it was incomplete because it was too objective. And I love being objective, but I think what makes me come on YouTube and listen to people talk for about an hour is the fact that they can give me something. They can give me an opinion. They can give me a little bit more than just reading a script. and following and analyzing a movie for what it is without adding themselves into their content. I wrote this poem when I was around 19, I would say, 19, 18 years old. I have never in my life had sex with anyone, but I still wrote Slow Dancing with the Man I fuck but never date. I toned it down in Portuguese because it was a little bit too harsh. It didn't sound too poetic at all. But I don't know why it should sound poetic. Anyway, I wrote this even though I've never been on a one-night stand, even though I've never had sex with anyone. But I do believe my desire to be intimate is greater than my desire to be tied down to someone. And it may seem a little bit paradoxical, since I do strive for a long-term relationship and a long-term connection. I want love. I want affection. Oftentimes, I wish that people would see me outside of the sexual context and just see me for who I am. Something like an object to admire, a figure in the distance. Oddly enough, the second thing that ever that I wrote in English reads as follows. I was always an ugly teenager. And that was why I was so obsessed with becoming pretty. I didn't just want to be attractive. I wanted to be fragile looking, like a pretty picture of a young, delicate girl. I wanted to be an image, a video circulating on people's mind. I didn't want to speak or to be known. I just needed to be admired and to inspire. Pretty people have the power to awake things in others, especially the most pure of urges and desires. They don't want you or your body, they want your face, or whatever they made you into in their own minds. Well, quite poetic. I rarely, like, not even rarely, I never show my writings to anyone, and I understand they can be a little bit bad, since, again, these are the only things I've ever written in English. I write everything in Portuguese, as weird as it sounds. But I think that idea of being like almost just a vision, just an object of admiration without them wanting to actually physically be with you. I think I longed for that for so long, because the moment, I think there is a difference when it comes to innocent love or like romantic love and then sexual love and sexual desires. And it was always very confusing to me. But I think now, as I've grown older, despite my belief of this, or my wanting of this perfect love, this perfect, innocent, pure love, I've grown fond of the idea of being wanted and desired. I think it is because I have a complicated attachment style, which is, I think it's called anxious avoiding or fearful attachment, in which you want something so much that when you get it, you eventually run from it, because I think you idealize it so much in your head that reality can never compare. And with the fear of being disappointed, you end up avoiding it completely, altogether. And so I think my complete belief that I want something serious, a true love, makes me go away from actually pursuing a relationship. But I'm a young adult. I'm developing. I'm a young woman, whatever you want to call it. And I think the lack of sexual relationships or just intimacy in general, for a lot of years, I have not been hugged. I have not been touched. I have not been kissed, even by friends. There's little contact, physical contact with people that I know. And I think this lack of sensory touch and of love just in general has made me wish that I was a one-night stand, or that I could love someone intensely for a moment, but knowing that I could let go at any time without having to be there completely, I would satisfy my desire to be hugged and to feel that intensity for a moment, but then I could just go away. I could just go away. I don't like to think that I'm a heartbreaker because I really don't break people's hearts. I don't go out there. I don't date. I don't anything, unfortunately. But I think that there is a part in me that can really hurt others, romantically speaking. I give everything that I have to my friends and friendships. But when it comes to liking someone in a romantic way, I tend to be very, I think, toxic. But it's not with the intention of hurting. I do it accidentally. I do it because I think I'm protecting myself. And I do admit that I'm selfish. And the only time this has happened to me and that I realized this behavior was when I was in 8th grade. And I've talked about this before. Which I had this boy who really liked me. I adored him immediately. I adored him completely. And I just left him. I didn't want to break up with him. I stopped talking with him. And he had to come to me to resolve things. That's the most immature thing someone can do. And I've spent, I think, up till now, all these years of my life deciding if I am a monster or not for doing that. Without even considering that I was a kid. Without allowing myself to initiate anything with anyone. Out of fear. Out of fear of committing the same mistake. And of putting someone through my ups and downs. And my lack of knowledge of myself. I think, doesn't matter how much I write. I can see a lot of things in these texts, and I sometimes read things that I've wrote before years ago, and I feel like I had understood. I understood it better than I do now. But at the same time, did I really? You know, I think there is this, I think I've heard this phrase somewhere, words would be just words till you bring them to life, and I've not, I can reflect, and I can analyze my behavior, but I haven't changed it completely. But at the same time, I haven't allowed myself to grow out of those behaviors because I don't put myself in situations where I know I could hurt someone. I think in response, I've hurted myself a lot more, and I've kept myself from experiencing a lot of things. But besides the trauma of my 8th grade relationship, I think there is another blockage that stops me from moving forward with anyone or trying out something new. And that blockage is what I'm trying to discover and the thing that does not come to me easily. I want to know it. I want to know it so bad, but it is invisible at this point. It's been 5, 6, 7 years? I don't remember. But I've never been able to discover it. I think maybe it's just in my brain. You know, it's just how I'm programmed to act. And I've never known anything different. But it seems unfair that I am unable to love people. And I am unable to be loved where everyone else in the world gets their chance. I also think that I'm too young to believe that I will never love anyone. I think just my deep desire for that can be beneficial to me. But unfortunately, I feel like there is a door blocking me everywhere I go. I go out with friends, and this is extremely bad to say, but I go out with friends. And I have two friends. One of my friends, she has hookups and stuff like that, everything. But I don't know her as well. And my closest friend, she's also in the process of trying to find love. She's never dated before. She's also my age. She's never dated anyone. She's never had a boyfriend. And she's absolutely obsessed with finding someone. I often thought that my feelings were invalid because I wasn't as obsessed with it as she was. But I think I am. I just don't express it in the way that she is much more open than me about it. But we go out, and inside of me, I felt very bad for saying this, but I felt like I was a tiny bit feminine, which doesn't mean anything than my friend. It doesn't mean anything in reality. People like everything and anything, and she's just a little bit more outspoken. She's more loud, and I don't think those are masculine characteristics, but I think that I'm a little bit more delicate, and I say delicate not in a good way. I say delicate in a bad way because I'm too afraid to voice my own opinions. I'm too afraid to be myself, and I get extremely awkward whenever I am in a different plane than my own house and my own and the places that I normally frequent. So it is also a big experience. I'm fine, so you know, but it is a little bit harder for me to just like completely like talk to a stranger, and she will immediately like will be in line, and she will just start talking to anyone. But if there are a group of guys, I don't think they're looking at me. Either I think they're looking at my friend, or they're looking at all of the thousands of other beautiful girls that are around us. I've always felt like that was a bit of like victim mentality, and I hated it because I hate victims. But I never assume that anyone is looking at me or that anyone wants me, because no one has ever shown that interest. For a long time, ever since I entered high school and all of that, I have just not been shown attention from boys. Not saying that they don't like find me attractive or anything. I wouldn't know, honestly. I think I look much better now, but I've never been approached. I've never been on a date. I've never experienced anyone falling for me, as one would say, whatever that means. For I think my most like formative years, and the years that people normally start dating and start getting into relationships. And I think there is a lack of knowledge from my part in how to live with someone completely. I'm too used to being alone. I'm too used to not being wanted or feeling like I'm not being wanted, and therefore I evade myself from the situation before they can admit that they don't like me. I think there is nothing more hurtful than painfully liking someone without them not even realizing it or not even being interested in you enough to notice. It is sad, but in my head, it was better than not being wanted at all. Because at least I had the illusion of maybe one day they'll find out. They never do. And so I do believe that going for people who I know will not reciprocate my feelings is another mechanism to deflect from the fact that I cannot accept love. And I cannot accept that someone would actually like most of me, or at least try to like most of me, or understand most of the person that I am. So I think striving for the impossible is a way of protecting my own integrity in a way. Like I said in the poem that I showed in the beginning, I don't want to take responsibility for holding on for too long, because I'm just lonely. That is all. I made myself believe that loneliness could be surpassed, and that I could learn how to live alone. But now that I'm a little bit older, I think the little egoism that I had when I was a little bit younger, and I thought that I was invincible in every way, kind of went away. And as much as I hate to ask for help, and that I hate to admit that I was wrong, or that I need something, or that I lack something, the truth is that I cannot live alone. I am an only child, and I feel like I have not much left. I don't have a strong family connection. Not that I don't see my family, but I don't. They don't live close to me, so I have this disconnect from them. And I've never really had that instinct of family and keeping everyone together. So I feel like all this time I've been trying to find stability and to find a base to build this foundation upon. But it is extremely hard, and I think especially I can blame modernity all that I want, and I can say that there is no such thing as family anymore. There is no such thing as traditional families. But I do not agree with that. I think there is a different kind of family, but it still exists, and as long as humans exist, it will continue and it will prevail, because it is the foundation of everything. You cannot have a child without both parents, no matter how hard we try to hide it, I believe. But intimacy and love are extremely scary, and I hate vulnerability, even though I recognize the importance that it has on these relationships, on these deep involvements with others and with other people. Still, I say too much and do too little, and that is my biggest flaw, and it will always be my biggest flaw. I think that what I failed to capture in the first video I posted was the fact that if you feel unloved, if you feel alone, you're not really in the position you think you are. I was trying to demonstrate that if you feel like you cannot connect with people in the depth that you want to, there are a bunch of people in the world who feel the same way, and I think most of us feel like there is a veil around us most of the time, and that the way that we present ourselves to the world doesn't allow everyone to see us deeply. Sometimes we're just a person that is there. Even though you know yourself that you're more than that, not everyone's gonna see it. You're not a main character. You're not special. At least to most people, you're not. But that doesn't mean that there is not a possibility of someone finding you special. I think we all like to compare ourselves to other people and to the relationships of others. I've seen people who I thought were like completely well off in long-lasting relationships completely break up, or I've known of certain situations within the relationship that really shocked me. Nothing is perfect. Everything involves work. And I think we all, as like, especially like this generation, I feel like we all are noticing this disconnect that we have from each other. And I think we cling a lot, like I said, to the media and to films and to books, to feel these emotions and to believe in these things. Because the moments or the scenes portrayed may not be real, but they were written by real people, oftentimes based on memories or on desires. So even in those impossible scripts, impossible stories, there is still a hint of truth, and there is still at the root of it the true desires of human nature. I think we all just really want to be understood and to be seen more than anything. And I think it will take effort from everyone around us to actually get to a point where we are all equally understood. But that's just an idealization. It is impossible. So I think we need to find people that do look out for us. And to myself, I give the advice of not running away from the possibility of experiencing something. I know that I cannot go into anything if I feel like it's not gonna last. But I shouldn't stop myself from feeling either way. And I need to remove myself from unrequired situationships, from unrequired crushes, from watching people from a distance and assuming they don't see me back. I think I've been focusing on the wrong things. And I feel like very recently I've awakened to some reflections that left me a little bit more at ease. Because for the first time, I felt like I was ready for something more. It has taken me a long time to actually believe that I could function in a relationship. And so why I did all this speaking just now. Analyzing everything. Analyzing behavior. Because I think this analysis that I was doing on myself constantly for years was just an excuse to not put myself through something unfortunate, in my point of view. And I believed, and I was right, I wasn't ready for anything, no matter how much I longed for it, no matter how much I wanted it, I wasn't ready. Because if I was so eager, even to just like be intimate with someone, even if we were not in a relationship, I guess I could have done it somehow. We're all young, I guess. I could have done it. If I wanted it so much, I could have done it. But I couldn't even do that. I couldn't even have a one-night stand or just go for it one time for the sake of doing it. I couldn't. Because I knew that I wasn't ready. I wasn't ready for a relationship and I wasn't ready for intimacy. There are a lot of things that are wrong with me. And that I assume, and that I know for sure that I cannot get past. But now I feel like I can let myself go a little bit more. I feel like maybe if I found someone, I wouldn't care so much. Where before I thought I could never do this with someone. I could never be that comfortable with someone. And I feel like that was so unfortunate, and I'm so happy that for a moment I thought I was ready. And I didn't think that because I was getting old, and like I should do it by now, like I'm getting old. I didn't think that. So I guess there's still hope. And I hope this wasn't too confusing. Audio in this video is better. I've been working on the other video for so long. And it felt so incomplete, and I was so sad because I've had it on my computer for a while now. And it just felt too rushed and too... It just felt bad. The audio was bad. The ideas maybe weren't as connected as I thought they were before. And I decided to do what I do best, which is to record myself speaking while I walk around the room with my phone, basically. I hope this made sense, and I hope that was a little bit interesting. I Hope to hear from everyone who has left comments. I'm so sorry for being gone for a while. I hope you can understand. I was having a hard time, but I want to do more, and I know that I don't function well with a lot of structure. I just need to be raw and be myself and speak for myself. And even if it is not everyone's cup of tea, this is what I do best. I tried structure, and I'm extremely dissatisfied with my own doings, but I hope you can all understand and at least enjoy something out of it and take something from it and discuss, or at least analyze even your own behavior the same way I do with mine. Not too much, of course. You don't want to end up like me. But I hope you all stay safe and see you in the next time.